بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم وبعد. الحمد لله والشكر لله سبحانه وتعالى that we Allah has given us the tawfiq opportunity to come to مدينة المنورة and here we are now in Uhud. Okay, Mount Uhud is the mountain that you see behind you. This is called Mount Uhud. Okay, that's the mountain behind you. It's called Mount Uhud. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, it's a hadith in Bukhari. Uhud جبل يحبنا ونحبه. Uhud is a mountain. It loves us and we love it. Now it's a hajar. It's a stone. I mean, this is. It has no life. Okay, there's no ruh in it. There's no spirit. But the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, this mountain actually loves the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And it is said whenever the Prophet used to go on a journey, and he used to come, okay, and then when he used to see Mount Uhud, the Prophet used to smile. Because you know that traveling in the olden days used to be very difficult, yeah? So you know, you have fatigue and you're tired. All of a sudden the Prophet is smiling. The Sahaba said, oh, Prophet, why are you smiling? He goes, don't you see Uhud? Uhud is waiting for us and we're waiting for Uhud. In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said that Uhud will be one of the gates of Jannah. Okay, once the Prophet ﷺ, he climbed actually Uhud, not right at the top, but a little. Okay, when the Prophet ﷺ climbed, he had Abu Bakr with him, Umar and Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhum. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Bakr, Umar and Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they went on top of the Uhud, Uhud began to tremble and shake. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is it, he's speaking to the mountain. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Uthbut Uhud. Oh Uhud, stay firm. Stay firm, stay calm. Why are you trembling? Why are you shaking? فَمَا عَلَيْكَ إِلَّا نَبِيٌّ وَصِدِّيقٌ وَشَهِيدًا. Because, O Uhud, you have a prophet standing on you. And you have a Siddiq, the fruitful one, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And you have two shaheed, the two martyrs. They are still living, but the prophet already gave them glad tidings that both of you will be martyrs. And guess what happened? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, obviously, when he left this world, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he had a natural death. And then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was
martyred.
And Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was too martyred. So that was a prophecy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anyway, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said about this Uhud, that this is Uhud, we love Uhud, and Uhud also loves us as well. What happened here is a battle. It's called the Battle of Uhud. You probably know. And if you haven't, then in quite briefly, I'll just tell you, there was a battle before that. It's called Battle of Badr. And Badr took place. Muslims were in 313. They only had 313. And the disbelievers, they had how many?
950.
Okay. Now look at the number and look at the numbers of the Muslims. But what happened? These 313, they were very sincere. Okay. And you know, they were Sahaba. And the Prophet made dua as well. Oh Allah. إن هلكت هذا القوم إن تهلك هذه العصابة فلن تعبد. Oh Allah, if you destroy these 313 that I have, and if they lose today, then no one will worship you. This is the dua that he made, and Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, he accepted the dua of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. كم من فئة قليلة غلبت فئة كثيرة بإذن الله والله مع الصابرين. Small numbers of people, 313, they become victorious over 950 and Muslim in that battle. Battle of Badr. What happened after that is the women of Mecca, they began to tease the disbelievers. Oh, what happened? How could you lose this battle? And etc. etc. And they began to tease them, and especially Hind. She said, oh, because she lost her family members. So she began to cry and she said, I must seek revenge. And then she was teasing Abu Sufyan, who was the leader. Oh, Abu Sufyan, what are you doing? You know, you call yourself a leader, you have money, and you're not going to do something. Go on, I want revenge. Then straight, you know, the Meccans, they got another army and they came. And the news reached the Prophet ﷺ that an army is coming from Mecca to attack the people of Medina. So the Prophet ﷺ, he concentrated here. What shall we do? The people said, oh Prophet of Allah, some said, let them come inside. Okay, some said, no, oh Prophet of Allah, we should go. Anyway, the nutshell is, the Prophet ﷺ, he took the people and he came here. And now you'll understand the intelligence of Rasulullah ﷺ, how intelligent he was. Even Khalid bin Walid, who was a commander, later he became a Sahabi. Okay, when he came here and he said, this man is a genius. Because he was a commander as well. إِنَّمَا يَعْرِفُ ذَا الْفَضْلُ مِنَ النَّاسِ دَوْهُ. A genius, he recognizes another genius. But this is Rasulullah ﷺ, of course. He's got revelation. So he came here, the Prophet ﷺ, he brought all the army here, the Muslim army here, okay? And when they come here, what the Prophet ﷺ did, he said, we will turn around and we'll face the kuffar on the other side, because we won't have any fear anyone attacking from behind. You've got the mountain behind, isn't it? If the Muslims were here and bringing the disbelievers in front of them, then you'll have the fear anyone could attack you from behind. The Prophet ﷺ, he said that, Muslim, we will be here, where we're standing, this is the area, all this, and he said, we will face them. Then the Prophet ﷺ said to 50 archers, and this is again, you know, the Prophet, you know, he was really intelligent, and also it's very easy for us to say because he is a prophet of Allah, revelations, he has direct contact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He sent 50 archers over there where these people are standing, and he said to them that under any circumstances, no matter what happens here, if you do not get my clear instruction to come down from there, do not come down from there. Okay, 50 archers, he took them there, so they all went there. And the Muslims are facing this way, isn't it? The disbelievers in the other side. Yeah? Now, the fight began. Because what happened was, you need to understand this, the Prophet, what's going to happen, the Muslim will fight and they will push forward and push forward. The Prophet feared that we will push the disbelievers back and back and back. And then what's going to happen? Maybe, you know, because, you know, when you have a battle, okay, maybe you will move to the left, okay? And then he might lose some of his companions, okay? So therefore the Prophet said that we will carry on moving forward this way. And the reason he kept this 50, that what's gonna happen, because we'll push them back, you know, maybe some of them, they run across this way and then they come around and attack them from the back. And once you're facing a direction and then someone's come from your back, how are you gonna fight? You're gonna fight this guy or you're gonna fight someone else? It's difficult, isn't it? So the Prophet ﷺ said, you lot stay here. And these guys, when they went there, they saw, they probably knew that, guess what? Khalid bin Walid was in the other corner who was waiting. But they had nothing to do with it because the vast number, the majority number was here. If they beat them, this guy will just run away anyway. And if they do come, these 50 archers, they are very expert. Sa'ad bin Abi Waqqas was the like of, and he does not miss, you know, they will take everyone down. So therefore, these people, they didn't have the guts to come, okay? So they stayed there. The fight took place, and Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was here, okay? And he was fighting and fighting, when he was moving forward, he ended up somewhere else. Basically, the way he was fighting, he wasn't even, anyone comes. You know, normally you fight one, then you wait for another one. He was basically had the sword in his hand, and he said, let's see who comes in front of me. And he ended up somewhere over there. And by the way, no one had the guts to come in front of Hamza. This is how he was, and everyone knows what happened was, Hind, she is the wife of Abu Sufyan, okay, she said to Wahshi ibn Harb, who was a slave of Hind and Abu Sufyan, she said, I will free you if you could kill Hamza for me. Because Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in Battle of Badr, you know, he killed Hind's father, isn't it?
Father, brother, uncle.
Yeah, okay. So he basically finished the whole family. So she wanted revenge. Hamza radiallahu ta'ala, who was in the, all of a sudden, you know, they, and Wahshi ibn Harb, by the way, he was an expert, you know, he was a harpoon expert. You know, he was expert at throwing
spears.
So he was actually following and waiting for Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu. By the way, you have to understand, Hamza was the most dearest uncle to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Anyway, and all of a sudden, he found Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu on an open field, and from the back, he attacked Hamza, where Hamza radiallahu ta'ala was shaheed. And I'll tell you quickly a little bit about him, just before we go to, you know, visit his grave, which is just behind us. And then what happened? The Muslim pushed them back, and the disbelievers, so many died, and a couple of them began to run. When these archers, they saw these guys are running, they said, Ya Qawm al-Ghanima, we've done it, we've won. Okay? And they left everything there and they all ran down here. And Khalid bin Walid said, guys, this is the time now, we will go. And these guys are facing this way, collecting booty, and some of the Muslims are already over there. By the time they could come and join this, Khalid bin Walid, with fast horses, he came round that, all the way round, came from here, and he attacked them from the back, and فَكَانَتْ الْهَزِيمَةِ. This is when the Muslims actually lost the battle, because they didn't know. Someone looking left, right, forward, they didn't know where them. Basically, it was all chaos here. They didn't know, they couldn't recognize what was happening. And this is how Khalid bin Walid came and he attacked. Anyway, later he became Muslim radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Guess what happened after that? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was pushed back. Now the Muslims are pushing back. He was pushed back so much that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he actually went right next to Uhud. Okay, and then they came and they actually found, you know, they hit him. They hit the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and here the Prophet of Allah lost two of his tooth, and he was bleeding from his mouth. Okay, and then obviously the Muslim came, they grabbed him, and they lift him up to the mountain because the horse couldn't reach there. And you know, and then the kuffar said, "Al yawmun lana wa yawmun alayna," because they're saying that we have a day is for us, and a day is against us. It means we win once, or we win and we lose. Okay, that's what they said. Because we lost the Badr, but we win this one. Okay, and then they said, "Lana al-Uzza wa la Uzza lakum." We have Uzza. Uzza is the name of an idol. And oh, people, Muslim, you have no Uzza. The Prophet said, all people reply to them, say, "Lana al-Mawla wa la Mawla lakum." We have Allah, our Mawla, our leader, and you don't have no Allah. Anyway, the battle then came to an end. They went away. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Aina Hamza? Where's my uncle Hamza? Why can't I see him? Where's Hamza? Ma fa'ala Hamza?" And it is said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was running in the battlefield looking for Hamza. You know, he's lifting lifting people's face to recognize it, but he can't find Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu. When all of a sudden he came, he saw the hand is cut, the nose is cut, the ear is cut, the liver is cut, and you know, his liver is actually taken out. Okay, and then he recognized just by half of the face left that, oh, this is my uncle Hamza. Upon then the Prophet cried, my brothers and sisters, that he never cried like this before. And then he looked around and said, "Oh, women, where are you? This, yeah? Why, where are the women? They cry, you know, on ridiculous occasion. This is the time to cry. Why are they not crying?" So all the women gathered to cry. Then the Prophet said, no, you don't need to cry. And then he said, the Prophet said, "Today, by looking at my uncle, the amount of hurt that I've got, I have never got hurt like this." And then the Prophet ﷺ, he, you know, himself, he grabbed Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu and he took him there just behind us. We're going to go now, inshallah ta'ala. And he buried him. And when he was burying him, he was crying. And then the Sahaba said, "Prophet of Allah, you're crying? Shall we cry with you as well?" He said, no, it's okay. And then the Prophet said, "Jibril just came to me." And Jibril said, "Allah has written this in the seven heaven, and all the angels are also singing the name of Hamza, and they're saying, Hamza tu asadullahi wa asadu rasuli. Hamza is the lion of Allah and the lion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, I don't need to cry anymore. I've been given these glad tidings." Anyway, this is in a nutshell. When you go back home, study the Battle of Uhud in detail, because here we go. You have Uhud, you could see. This is the arches were there. Okay, that's called, you know, Jabal al-Rumat. It's not, and this is Uhud, and this is the Shuhada of Uhud. Okay, this is where Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu and many other Shuhada were buried. Okay, the 70 Shuhada and 70 Sahabi, and also we have, as I said to you, Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So what do? We go inside. It's written there, "Assalamu alaikum ahla al-diyar min al-mu'minina wal-muslimin. وإنا إن شاء الله بكم لاحقون نسأل الله لنا ولكم العافية." Read Surah Fatiha and read قل هو الله, and then inshallah make a small dua and we will go away. Can you see, you know, you could see Hamza radiallahu anhu grave. Can you see those bricks? Yeah, look, the bricks in front of us. That's where Hamza radiallahu anhu is. Okay,
the first Bismillah. The second one, or just the massive one. Thank you.